In Revelation 2 and 3, Jesus sent special messages to seven churches. He commended the things in them that were commendable, but He also called them to repent in the areas where they were falling short of what God intended for His people to be. Jesus created the church for us to carry out His redemptive work to the world. And He wants us to be the people He created us to be, that His Holy Spirit dwells in us in order to enable us to be. Wouldn't you love to hear a message from Jesus customized to your church in a time like this when we're having to evaluate what we are going to be in the days to come? There are things that we need to hold on to and hold precious and to never let those go, but there may be other things that Jesus would say for your world in your church. Here's what you need to be. Here's what you need to change. There may even be things that God would Himself call us to repent and turn from the things that are not according to His plans and purposes for His church. I've written a book to try to help you do just that. It's called Return to Me, and it comes from a scripture in Malachi 3:7, where God, out of a deep burden and love for His people, He pleads with His people, "Return to Me." He understands that His people at that time were living a life far short of what God intended, and they were missing out on the life and vitality and fruitfulness that He intended for them. So He makes that heartfelt plea, but then He gives this wonderful promise. Return to Me, I will return to you. And I don't know about you, but I want God to return to me and to my church, to fill us with His purpose and His Spirit so that we will bear much lasting fruit that remains. Jesus made this statement to His disciples. He said, "I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it." Now, gates are a defensive mechanism to hold inside those things that are supposed to be inside the gates of hell, and to keep outsiders from having any influence on that. And Jesus said, "When I build my church the way I intend, even the gates of hell will not prevent us from accomplishing the task." We need to be that kind of church. And what I've done in this resource is try to help your church examine six particular areas that we need to make sure that we're the people God wants us to be. I'll be helping you to love God. We need to love Him with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength. We need to return to Jesus as our first love. We need to love one another and demonstrate our love in tangible ways toward one another. And then beyond that, we need to love a lost world and allow God to work through us to love a lost world in such a way that they experience the love of God. And God uses that to draw them to saving faith in His Son. Then the third thing we need to do is surrender all. We as individuals need to live with Jesus Christ as our Lord. And we need to submit to His sovereign rule in our hearts and lives. But we also as a church need to restore Jesus Christ as head of His church. He is the only head of His church. And when He functions as head and each member functions in its appropriate place in the body, then we function the way God intended for us to function. So we need to surrender all. The fourth thing we need to do is be transformed. We need to be holy as God is holy. We need to allow God to cleanse and wash away and out of us the things that are not like Christ, and to mold and shape us into the image of Christ Himself, so that when people meet me and you, they see Jesus in us without any human pollution or distortion. So we need to be transformed. Then we're ready to join God's mission. God's got a mission for us. He's given us a final command. He's given us the power of His Spirit. And He has work for us to do. And even Jesus, as He said to His disciples, go cast out your nets for a catch. God would say that to us as fishers of men for our day, to let down our nets for a catch. There is a harvest God wants to bring in our world. And so we need to join God's mission and allow Him to work in us and through us to make the gospel of Jesus Christ appealing to those that God will draw to Himself and to His Son, Jesus Christ. And ultimately, we need to glorify God. We need to let the nations hear of the glory of God. We need to live our lives in such a way that they see our good works and glorify the Father who's in heaven.